Well, as unusual as it is, good morning. It is Friday, the 5th of January in the year of our Lord 2024, and this is our weekly devotional. We're a couple of days late, but we now have a good fast internet connection, and we're at son's house here in the Cocoa Beach area. We're visiting for a few days and he's got good internet, so I decided to strike while the iron was hot here and get our recording done for this week. So welcome, and we apologize for not being able to broadcast while we were on the road. We promise that we do this and keep it on the Facebook page so that you can watch it whenever you have time to do that. And so this week we have to, I guess, have to accept this. That's Bagheera, the cat here. You can see in the side, and that's Isabel up there behind my right shoulder. She's not too interested with any of this, but Bagheera seems quite curious about what's going on. He's a pretty good guy. And there's another one that looks a little bit like him that's floating around here, Jar Jar. You may see him pop in and out here as we go. But anyway, we're going to have to take some of our own allowance this week and broadcast when we have everything in one place where we can have. This is going to be a little bit of an abbreviated broadcast because I don't have all the pieces and parts here. I need to put the full broadcast together, but it shouldn't look too much different to you, other than maybe some few less parts, moving parts. So thank you for tuning in, and we're going to move into. Let's see if I can get some music uploaded. If I can, we'll do that. If we can't, if you hear music next, you'll know we were successful. If you don't, you'll know we weren't. And then we'll move into our sermon today. So stay with us, and we'll be right back with you.
Come, Holy Spirit, wish on me. Fill me with your power. Satisfy my need, yeah. 'Cause only strength to make me grow. Come Holy Spirit, fall fresh on me. 'Cause only you can make me whole. Give me strength.
Well, this week we have several prayer concerns that have been brought to our attention. Pleased to know that Nadia is continuing to improve, even though that improvement is very slow and painfully slow some days. But the progress seems to be fairly steady, and so we're just so grateful that prayers are being answered there for Nadia and her family. And we continue to lift up Rick, who has been battling not only cancer, but pneumonia and some other problems. Pleased to let you know that he is home and recovering there. We're going to lift up Pastor Allen, who has had a hip replacement done, but is having some complications with that. So we need to lift him up in prayer this week. Our special prayer this week is for Connor. He is a young man who's fighting a brain tumor. He's in the area of a church that we have previously served, and they attempted to do some surgery this week, were not successful. They discovered that the way they had planned to remove this tumor would do way far too much damage, and so they had to rethink. And they closed him back up, and next week are going to use a different type of procedure on him. He is in the hospital, will stay in the hospital until the second surgery is done and it's safe for him to leave. As with any of that type of surgery, there's a risk involved. And so we just need to lift Connor and his family up in prayer this next couple of weeks. Hoping that they will have a good result and this tumor will be able to be completely removed and that we'll be able to, he will be able to go on living the life that he should be able to live as a normal teenage young man. So his student's body, we lift them up in prayer as well as they are in support of him and praying. Other schools have taken this up and are praying and having Team Connor on their listed on web pages and Facebook pages and all sorts of things. So people are just coming together wonderfully for this young man, and we just pray that there will be a very successful result here, and that Jesus will hear our prayers and that they will be answered, allowing Connor to return to his normal life. So we're praying for, we're asking for prayers for safe travels as we continue to our destination. And then as we return home later on, we ask for prayers for our brick and mortar church that we're serving right now at Spencerville Trinity, that that God will keep them safe and relatively trouble-free while we're away. We pray for the church leadership that will be leading and guiding them in our absence. And we just pray that everything will go well and that he'll keep everybody safe till we can be back and continue shepherding the flock there. So I know that's a lot of stuff, but very important things that we're lifting up in prayer this week. So will you bow with me in prayer? Lord Jesus, we come this week, hat in hand, asking for much. Healing for cancer victims, healing for transplant replacement surgeries, and just all manner of difficulties that people are facing. We pray that you will lift them up, that you will heal their bodies, that you will be with their families as they wait and watch and worry and wonder. And Lord, we just can't thank you enough for the prayers that have been answered and are being answered every single day. And for your abiding presence, knowing that you are always ready, more ready to listen than we are to pray. And we thank you, Lord, for always being there for us, for always answering prayers. And we pray for forgiveness when sometimes we don't understand the reasons behind the answer that you have for some of our prayers, but help us to have the faith to know that you are in charge and that you know best and that we need to trust you. And Lord, we pray for all those who suffer from addictions, those who are in nursing homes and in rehabilitation facilities, in hospitals, and just all manner of treatment centers. We pray for those who are struggling with addiction. We pray for those in prison. We pray for those who are people without a country, people who have been driven from their homes by wars, by violence, by killings, by all manner of violence and just horrible things that are going on. We pray for the Middle East and for peace there, that all of the leaders in that area will come to the realization that your way is a way of peace and not of war. We pray for the families that have been torn apart, who have lost mothers and fathers and children, and just so much death and destruction, and we lift them up. And for people in the Ukraine, we pray for our enemies, those who hate us, and we pray that they will also see that that your way is a way of peace and love. And Lord, we pray for the victims of the shootings all over the country here. And we pray for those who perpetrate those crimes, whose hearts have been hardened by something in life. And we just pray for them and for their souls. Lord, we lift up prayers of thanksgiving for us, for safe travels so far on our trip, for all the blessings that we see every day, some of which we don't even recognize as blessings, and answered prayers. And we just thank you so much for all that you do in our lives, for the blessings of family, for the blessings of our individual churches, including this one, and other brick-and-mortar churches that people may attend. And we are just so thankful for our church families who come together and support and assist us as we move along in life. And most of all, Lord, we thank you for Jesus, who loved us enough to die for us and who taught us these words to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We're going to move on to our message, and our scripture will be embedded in our message today. So stay tuned. Well, in case you're wondering, we are on our annual pilgrimage to Florida. We're in Florida, as I mentioned just a little bit ago, in the Cocoa Beach area. Right now, we'll be here till through the weekend, and then we're going to head down to our permanent site down near Arcadia. So, hope you'll forgive the tardiness this week. As I said, we haven't had the parts all in one place, particularly a high-speed internet connection where we upload these things. Hope you enjoy what we've been able to put together for you. I was talking to my wife, DJ, the other night on our way down the road, and she recalled a time when she was teaching school. She was a special education teacher. And she said that she taught little kids, preschool and early elementary age kids. And during one particularly hard rain, the roof of the classroom she'd been assigned to began to leak, and leak really badly. And the water was pouring through the ceiling and running down the wall. And over an electric outlet box, which it soaked thoroughly and then ran on down below that and onto the floor where it was puddling up. And she noticed that there were bits and pieces of ceiling tile that were being washed down with it. And, you know, those 12 by 12 inch tiles that every school had on the ceiling. And back in the early days of education. And she knew that she had several concerns. First of all, her students were special needs students. And secondly, she was very concerned about the electrical outlet because it was, it was soaking wet and the water was running through it and down on the floor. So she was concerned about the possibility of electric shock if one of the kids should get close to it. And then the third concern that she had was about the ceiling tile residue and bits and pieces that were coming down the wall. Because she knew that they contained asbestos, which when it dries out, they would probably or possibly contain asbestos, and that would turn to dust and put her kids at risk there as well. So she went to the appropriate administrator and voiced her concerns, but as the day wore on, nobody showed up to check and see if it was a hazard or if there was any problem with it, any hazard connected to it. She kind of cordoned off the area as best she could, but there was nothing being done. So she finally went and voiced her concerns more aggressively, I guess. She said in no uncertain terms that somebody needed to come and look at that, at the situation there in the classroom and make sure that her kids were safe. And she said that because she was new to the position and was assertive in the way that she went and talked to the administrators. She felt that, and even though that she'd had good evaluations from her supervisor throughout the year, she's pretty sure that that's why that her contract wasn't renewed that following year for the following year. And so she said it was a job that she absolutely loved. She loved working with that age kids. And she ended up having to move to another district where she could work. And after she told me that story, my response to it was, sometimes you have to do the right thing just because it's the right thing to do. And sometimes you have to do that when there's no personal gain in doing so. And sometimes you have to do the right thing even when it may be detrimental to your own being or your own needs and desires in life. And Jesus spoke about this. I'm going to take us to our scripture for the evening in Matthew chapter 7, verses 13 and 14. Jesus said, "Enter through the narrow gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction, and many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life, and only a few find it." Sometimes we have to do the thing that is most difficult because it's the right thing to do, even if the results are detrimental to us over the short term. Jesus acutely understands that. He had to suffer humiliation, beatings, and excruciating, painful death to care for those of us who have been entrusted to him. He left us with that example for how to live our lives. So, we need to look at life through a little bit different lens than we may other under circumstances other than those that make us a Christian. Because sometimes we have to do the right thing just because it's the right thing to do. And sometimes that causes us more problems than just kind of turning a blind eye to it and letting it go. What would Jesus do is what we need to ask ourselves when we run into those situations. And what Jesus would have us do is to do the right thing, because that's what he did. And doing the right thing caused him huge amounts of pain and suffering and humiliation and even death on the cross, a painful, excruciating death. And, to pay the price for our sins, not because it's the easy thing to do, but because it was the right thing to do. So I'm just going to leave you with that thought for this week. Sometimes we have to do the right thing just because it's the right thing to do. And I hope that my prayer for you will be that you have the courage, that when the time comes, that you will have the courage to do that without having to consider the consequences of that, or without having to allow the consequences to influence how you react or act on something like that. So we thank you for listening in. Again, we apologize for being late this week. Will you bow with me in prayer? Lord, as Christians, may we always strive to do the right thing just because it's the right thing to do. Give us the strength and the courage and the wisdom to be able to differentiate and to discern those times, and then to act appropriately when we encounter them. And we pray this in the holy name of Jesus, our Savior. Amen. Well, we hope you've enjoyed our broadcast this week, and that it's been helpful to you in your walk with Christ. And we'd hope to be able to broadcast from outside amongst the palm trees, and the warm weather is supposed to be 73 today, at low of 69 tonight. So we're thankful for the warm weather, but the wind is blowing, and there's an airport nearby, and there's been a fair amount of noise from all of that, and the wind's blowing, and it causes problems with our mics. So we just decided to broadcast from within the house today, and we'll try and bring that to you maybe next week. We'll watch for a nice calm day to do our recording. So until then, please accept this blessing. May the Lord watch between thee and me while we are absent one from another. Amen. Remember, we love you and God loves you, and there's nothing you can do about it. We're so glad you joined us. We're so glad that we were able to get this broadcast away this week, even though it's a couple of days late. And again, we pray, our prayer is that you that it helps you just feel a little bit closer to Jesus this week. Until next week's broadcast, good night, good day. Old habits die hard, and God bless.